Welcome back. In today's tutorial, I'm going to show you how we can change baseline level in categorical variable for linear regression. And the software I'm using today is ExcelStat. First of all, let's take a look at the data set we have. This is a rather interesting data set. As you can see, there are like a lot of rows. This is a data set that contains the most popular travel destinations in the world, according to Google Maps. And there is a total of about 1,300 rows. So there's a lot of data. And I really like to go over the variables, that's the columns here as well. So first of all, the column A is a city. And if you go to data and you enable filter, you can see that there's I think there's only 10 cities that's used here. Bangkok, Dubai, Hong Kong, New York City, Paris, and Singapore. So the next one we have is the travel destination, which is named, for example, Disneyland in Hong Kong, Ocean Park in Hong Kong. The next column we have is review count, the total number of people, total number of reviews received by that destination. So the numbers actually vary quite a bit, as you can see. So it ranged from, you know, for example, some of them actually had no reviews or maybe non-reviews were collected, and some other travel destination has thousands or maybe tens of thousands of reviews. The next one we have here is rating, which is a numerical variable range from 1 to 5. And most of the city destinations, as you can see, they have rather high rating. The following variable is category. So some of the destinations, theme park, park, or maybe city park, a lot of park, as you can see, temple, or maybe just a scenic spot. And there are some attributes for this destination. We also have their longitude and latitude information as well. Okay, and so first of all, I like to do a little bit manipulation with the review count. And the reason I want to do that is because the review counts actually vary drastically. Later on, when we do a linear regression, we probably want to explain one single change in the review count, how is that going to affect some other variable. But we have hundreds of thousands of reviews, so we probably want to measure it in terms of thousands. So the review I'm going to have here, the variable I'm going to create, is going to be review count measured in thousands, right? Okay, so I'm going to put an equal sign, this one divided by 1,000. And so I move the cursor to the lower right corner until I see a black solid cross. I double click on it. This works for both PC and Mac. As you can see, the numbers are being populated. But I actually don't like this number. The reason is because this number is a whole number. I want to have at least 2 decimals. So I'm going to right click here, format cells, and go to number. I want to have at least 2 decimal places. Click OK. Great. Okay. Because I want to do a regression, so what I'm going to do is I will try to predict one numerical variable. We don't have a lot of numerical variables here. I'm going to focus on rating. Rating sounds to be a very reasonable variable that you try to predict or estimate. So we want to estimate the rating of a destination. It's going to be a number between 0 and 5, as we talked about earlier. So this is going to be our dependent variable, or y. So this is the variable we try to predict. And to predict this variable, I'm going to use several independent variable or x's here. So first of all, I feel like review count is probably going to be useful for to predict rating. So I'm going to use this variable. And as you can see, this is a numerical variable. And the next one I want to use is I want to use the city. We have 10 of those. And the reason I want to do that is because maybe there's some kind of effect coming from the city. So the rating received by a destination may be influenced by the city of that destination, right? And clearly this is a categorical variable. So this is a categorical X, and this one is a numerical X. Okay, so let's begin. First of all, click on ExcelStat. Modeling data, linear regression. I'm going to use the linear regression to do that. So this is the dialog box that you guys received. So first of all, I always like to click on the lower left corner to reset it. Okay, so everything's being reset. I'm going to go to the fourth icon here and click. Okay, so I'm going to use the mouse here, and the mouse is going to help me to select the variables easily. So first of all, y dependent variable. So we only have one of them. The dependent variable is rating. So I'm going to put my cursor here and click on rating. Yes. And the next one is x, which is explanatory variable. So there's a quantitative, which is numerical. There's a qualitative. We want to use both of them. So for the quantitative, which is numerical, I'm going to use the review count measuring in thousands that's just being created. And the next one we have is going to be qualitative, which is the city. So I'm just going to put it here and click on here so everything is being selected. Okay, pretty much the rest of the options, you can just keep them as default. You don't have to do any change here. Click OK. Okay, depends on your computer. It may take a while for you to spit out the results because this data is not tiny. You have 13,000 rows. Okay, so this is the output we have. And if you have been watching my video, you probably know that I always like to click on the second icon here. So that removes all the grid, which makes the presentation much cleaner, right? And we do receive a bunch of summary statistics, which are useful as well. So for example, for our rating, we see that our minimum is 1 to 5, and the average is about 4.4. No surprise, those the destinations we talked about, they are the most popular, mostly visited travel destinations. So the ratings have to be high. And we also have review count measuring in thousands. So the destination with the highest review counts is actually 300,000. That's a very popular destination. And the average is about 9,000. And there are a bunch of other variables as well. For city, we have 10 cities, as 10 values, as you can see. So 10 of them. You have their frequency. For example, about 10%. They're pretty much equally distributed. I would say almost all of them is 10%. New York City has about 10.8%. And the next thing I like to do is let's take a look at the R-square. R-square is not extremely high, it's only about 16%. You should not be surprised. A lot of times, in order to predict the rating of a destination received, the variables we used in this study, which is just the city, and also the reviews, are probably not extremely helpful in explaining ratings. But in any case, about 16% of the variation in your Y, in your rating, in your ratings, was able to be explained by our model. Okay, and the ANOVA table with a very small p-value, which indicates that this is a useful model as well, right? Useful model, right? And let's take a look. So what we also have here is a model coefficient table. This is a very important table. This actually gives us all the slope estimates, right? So with the information here for the value, those are the slope estimates, we should be able to write down the model. And you can also tell which of the variables are important by taking a look at the p-value. If it has a very small p-value, that means this variable is significant in estimate the rating of the destination. For example, the review count is very important, is a positive number. So the more reviews a destination receives, the more likely the ratings are going to be high. It's going to be higher. And for destination in Hong Kong, we see that their ratings tend to be a little bit lower compared to other cities. And same goes for Macau and Paris. When I say compared to other cities, there's a question that comes into mind. What exactly do I mean by other cities? So that's an excellent question, because we have 10 cities, you probably remember, 10 of those, and we have to pick one of the cities to use as our reference level or baseline. Well, ExcelStat has already done that for us. For this particular data set, ExcelStat decided to use Singapore as the baseline. How do I know that? It's because the estimate is estimated to be zero. And you can see the rest of the row for Singapore is left blank. So Singapore is used as a reference level, right? So all the estimates we received here are all compared to Singapore. For example, Macau, which is not too far away from Singapore in physical distance. It receives, on average, about 0.3 less rating, and it's a significant factor. So the ratings for destination in Macau tends to be 0.3 less than another destination in Singapore. And provided the review count for those two destinations about the same. Let's see. Okay, for another destination in London, they tend to be receiving 0.07 rating higher than another destination in Singapore compared to Singapore. How do I know that? Because this is a positive number, right? This is also highly significant, right? Okay. And what we're going to do next is I'm going to write down our model. Okay, so let's take a look at our model so I can fill in the blanks. And so first of all, this is a estimated model, estimated rating. So the first number you're going to fill in is going to be the intercept, which we have here, as you can see. And for the review count, which is measured in thousands, right? And I'm just going to put down that is a 0.002. Make sure you always copy the negative sign as well. Build all of the numbers into the equation. As you can see, all of them are given here. I copied it from the table. And Singapore does not appear in this equation. That is because Singapore is used as the baseline. Okay. Just say that you are not very happy with this model. And you don't want to compare every single city with Singapore. Instead, you might be interested in comparing all the cities with New York City instead. And so how would you do that? So that means you have to tell Excel Stat to use New York City instead of Singapore as the baseline. So first of all, you have to know why Singapore was chosen as the baseline according to Excel Stat. For a categorical variable, the value of the variable that starts with the last letter is always used as the reference level for Excel Stat. For example, for this data set we have Bangkok that starts with a B, and Kuala Lumpur starts with a K, New York City starts with N, and Singapore starts with S. Among all the variables here, S is the last letter. So that's why Singapore is used as the reference line. If we do want to use New York City as the baseline, what we can do is we can change the value of all New York City to something else to make sure that new value starts later than any other city is here. Okay, so let's see how we can do that. This is the data set we have, and the cities were saved in the first column. And I'm gonna replace all the values for New York City with something that's gonna make sure that new value is gonna start later than everything else. You probably know that you want to add a Z in front of New York City. So let's do that. I'm going to use a replace function here. So it's Control F in both PC and Mac. New York City by Z, New York City. I guess you can replace this variable by any name you like, as long as it starts with a letter Z and you know that's being referred as New York City. And you can use capitalized Z or small letter Z, but small letter Z is considered later than capitalized Z for Excel Stat. So we're gonna replace all of them. As you can see, all the replacements being made. I'm just gonna go back to this sheet that was created earlier on when we were running the linear regression. And I'm gonna go back here, click on triangle, which is gonna bring back the dialog box we worked earlier on. And do make sure that all the variables are selected as you intend them to. So quantitative variable, D variable review count, and also CD for A. So that's everything is pretty much the same. Click OK, and the regression is being run. It may take a little bit longer. Okay, so remove all of them. Let's take a look at the result. So you can see instead of New York City, I have Z New York City. And this is the coefficient table we like. New York City is being used as the baseline. All other cities is compared with New York City. So for example, Macau has a negative coefficient, negative 0.364. So a destination in Macau usually has a 0.36 rating lower than New York City, right? And Hong Kong is also 0.32 lower than New York City. And yeah, that's pretty much it. I guess if you want to complete this exercise, what you want to do is you want to fill in all the blanks here, like what we did early on. And you can see those coefficients are going to be changed because for the first exercise, Singapore was used as a reference level. And for the second one, New York City is used as a reference level. So it's pretty neat, huh? Great. I guess that's the end of this video. And do feel free to let me know if you have any questions. And feel free to comment. And I'm going to put up this data set on YouTube. You can also find other teaching videos on my channel as well. Great. Thank you so much for watching.